Hello everyone, welcome back to NetClub channel. Now in this video, we're going to talk about how do you provide visual feedback when a data is being loaded from the database. When the data is loading, like you see, as soon as I click on this all, now the whole button or the whole form doesn't get updated. So the user doesn't know that the request is being processed. So the person can keep clicking on this button for several times because there's no indicator. Now to indicate that the page is loading, how I can do it. If I click on this top button 5, instead of the user to click multiple, I want to display just an image that is a loading image. So a person know that, okay, fine, my request is being processed, so as you wait. Okay, so first of all, you see, since we have small data here, as soon as I click on this, everything gets what? Processed. Now let's add a delay to this. And let's understand what I'm actually talking about. So in order to add a delay, let's see, this is what you're going to do. You're going to add sleeping or threading. You're going to sleep the process. So this process, we started this previously, so you can check on the previous video to actually understand that. Here we are doing just a modification to the project that we started earlier on. So in here, let's add threading. So system.threading.thread. Then we have sleep, it should sleep for, let's say this 5 seconds. So let's copy this. So each of these is going to sleep for 5 seconds. And it's going to delay the total, it's going to delay the process. Okay, so now let's see. Let's save this. Now let's run this and see the delay. So it's going to delay for 5 seconds. And when the user click on the button and there's no response, maybe the user might think that the website is not even, or the application not even responding, or it is not good, or can keep clicking on the button. Because there's nothing to display, nothing to show. Let's see. If I click on all, now you see nothing happens. But it is processing. It's delaying for 5 seconds. Okay. When it is done, you could see the data has been displayed. If I click on this top 5, you could see I've clicked on that, but nothing happens. It's delaying for 5 seconds. Now, in case of this, can I have just image to display or to tell the user that it is loading? So the user won't just be clicking on this button anyhow. That's what you're going to do. I hope you've gotten the idea. All right, so let's see. The first thing to do here is to download an image. So you can see I have this image here. You can download it from, this is a GIF loading. So you can grab it from the internet and you can just download that. Else, if you want to create your own one, there's also a useful website. That's spiffygif.com. You can just go to that to create your own spinner images. Now what you do here is create a folder in your application. Now the folder that you're going to create, let's pass in that. So create a folder and now let's put that image in. So I have a folder here and I have the image. So that's the spinner image in the images folder. The next to do here is we're going to design this image folder. So let's copy this image. Now in an index where you have a page being loaded. So that's an index page. Let's put it beneath. So at down here. So let's see, we can actually bring break, then break again. Now let's put this here. Okay, so now this is what you're saying. Now this is the ID of the image, the div, and now we are having the source is equal to images slash, so images. And now let's go in there and grab the name of this spinner. So let's change this to spinner.gif. Okay, so we have spinner. .gif. So let's copy all this and now let's come and paste it over here. So spinner.gif, that is a file, and then the root is images. Okay, and now this width and height, let's take that off. Now let's save this. So initially it is not going to be displayed. That's why you have a class. So d here may display as none. That is a bootstrap class. But in case you want to have its own class, can set up a style, and this style can set display is equal to, you can set your to none, you can set like this. Okay, so once you have this, what's the next thing to do? We are going to now update the action links by adding this. So loading element ID, then you pass in the div name. So in our application, in the index, you see we have here, so we're going to add this loading element ID, then you pass in the ID of what the div here. So that's a div spinning or spinner loading. So let's copy this and let's update all the table. So we're going to update this. Let's update and let's update this as well. So now let's save. And now that is all. So that's a simple step to actually work on. Now let's save this and now Control plus F5. Let's run this application and see what's going to happen now. So you see from here, you can just click on this button and grab you the test. But let's see why this gets loaded. Let's see how it's going to work with the Spinner GIF image. Okay, so this is like providing a visual feedback. These are going to know that, okay, fine, my data is being processed, so I should now wait. So let's see, as soon as I click on this, you can see, let's see what's going to happen. So you can see the page is not displaying, but the process is being utilized. So we have this. So let's see the reason why you are not having that. So let's try to add a BG Duck to this class, that image class. Okay, so BG Duck, we can set the background to be black. Now let's refresh this. Now let's see if actually working over here. So let's click on this and let's see. All right, so now let's build this again. Control plus F5. Let's try to figure it out. So you must have the image displayed. All right, so first of all, this is what we're going to do. Let's take off this class. And now let's save this and let's see what's going to happen. So refresh this. Now you can see we have the spinner image here. So let's take off the BG. Let's see if that is making it look like white. So when we refresh this, okay, we have this here, right? Okay, so this is what we're going to do. So let's set a class this. Let's use a CSS style. So here, let's set the style. Then let's set display to none. Okay, so let's set this. And now let's refresh our page and see. So we shouldn't see this symbol over here. Now let's click on this and see what's going to happen. So you can see we have it over here. Now loading. And now you can see we have this. And as soon as it is done, it's off. Click on this again. And you can see we have the image beneath here. And it is still loading. So this is going to provide a visual effect to the user to know that fine, my data is being processed. So the same thing applies to, and it is now loaded. So I hope this can actually help the user not to be clicking this several times. Because as soon as you click on that, you know the data is what being processed over here. Alright, so that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully I hope this is clear. And I'm going to see you in the next video.